through the principle of enculturation. That is why here, the plan of original plan was to translate the modules in 7 official Filipino languages. But the Archbishop Balyes decided just to give the modules in English and for the catechetical directors of dioceses to translate and enculturate these modules in their respective contexts. And third is fidelity to the Church, which is ecclesial forming. At the end of the day, all catechetical work should bring about a transformation of Church in the service of the larger community. This is the third principle identified by the NCDP. In the preparation for the Facilitator's Guide for Children, we decided to only have 4 modules for the children. These are for the grade schoolers. The catechesis for children will hopefully cultivate the love for the Eucharist and devotion to the Blessed Sacrament. So fathers, at the end of the day, we would want that catechists invite the children to do daily visitations of Jesus in the Most Blessed Sacrament. Try to cultivate that, particularly in our schools, both public and private, enable the children to have a good practice of visiting Jesus just for some seconds or minutes, just to say hello to Him. So at the end of the day, we would want to encourage that. The highlights are these. These are the 4 modules for children. The Eucharist as Christ's work of redemption realized. The Eucharist as a sacrament of love. The Eucharist as the source and goal of dialogue with Jesus. And Mother Mary as the first disciple of Christ that leads us to the Eucharist. So only 4 very simple modules for the children. For the youth and adults, we have the following modules. Expanding the 4 modules for children, we have decided to expand it because of the mission theology that we would want to bring down to good catechetical work. And once again, this conference is connected to the points raised by Bishop Francis yesterday and our very able speakers, Father Edgar and Monsignor Benko. So we would want in our discussion to have a unique Asian flavor to the Eucharistic Congress, which is Church in Dialogue. In Ireland, the focus is Church as Communio. That was the last, the 50th IEC. But in Asia, we would want to strengthen the mission angle of the Eucharist. So the tripod, as identified by Father Edgar in his talk, is Eucharist in the Church's dialogue with other religious cultures, Eucharist in dialogue with the poor, Eucharist in dialogue with the youth, and Mary and the Eucharist in the Church's mission. The 4th agenda proposed by Father Edgar is not here, which is the dialogue with ecology. But uniquely, that was identified by Pope Francis in the Evangelii Gaudium, citing the CBCP pastoral on ecology. But one thing that we would want to highlight is Eucharist in the Church's dialogue with the youth. So there's a specific module on dialoguing with young people, because Asia is a young continent, meaning majority of Asians are below 30 years old based on the statistical data. The 8th module is always on the Blessed Mother and the role of the Blessed Mother in the Eucharistic life, and the Eucharist and the glory of God, and the powerful image that is found in the Mother document approved by Rome is that the Eucharist in Asia underlines the great messianic banquet, the pagsasalo-salo ng mga tao. So there are 10 modules. Now, please take note. 10 modules that could be expanded to 25 or to 30 modules. Please take note, it's a bit content heavy. That is why we leave it to your ingenuity and creativity to extract from the modules the specifics of what you want to highlight in your catechesis with the elders or with the over 30 years old. What are the learnings? Learnings are the following. First of all,